Welcome to our channel Pioneer of Success and Online Free Educational Institute. Today we will be continuing our Autocad Lecture Series. So just before that, let me introduce myself. My name is Atish Ghosh. I am a B.Tech student of Jadavpur University, Mechanical Engineering Department. My Quora profile link and LinkedIn profile link is given in the description right below. If you have any queries regarding to the videos, you can mention in the comment section or you can direct message me. If you like our content, please subscribe to our channel.
So welcome to our second lecture in AutoCAD tutorials, and in our previous video we have discussed about the important elements which will be used in our drawing in AutoCAD. So in this tutorial we will be going to discuss how to drawing a template in AutoCAD. So just open the AutoCAD software at first, and this is AutoCAD 2007, and just go to the then layout window and just delete the previous existing viewports, just delete it. Then here go to the layout option, okay, and just right click it and go to the page setup manager. This is here, click the modify option, this, and here just change the printer option according to your printer, and now change the paper size here. Change the paper size. I will be keeping it at A4. Now click OK and close it. Okay, now it has become a A4 size set. Get some new layers. So just click here this option, and just click here. And now go to new layer. This one is the new layer. You can see it. This one is the new layer. Click on it and here just rename it. With this layer, I will be drawing only viewport, so I will be leaving it viewport. And changing the color to red, and the line will be continuous line with thickness of 0.35. And this is perfect. Okay. Now I need one more line for text lines, so I will be renaming it as text. The color, I will be changing the color to blue, and continuous line, and this is the thickness will be 0.18 mm. So now click OK, and in the drop down menu we can see we have got two lines, text and viewports. So just go to the viewport and select a rectangle and draw a rectangle map with utilizing the maximum area in the echo sheet paper. And now I have to offset it. This one is the offset option. This one, you have to click on this one. Okay. Now click on it. I have to specify the offset distance. So I have to specify offset distance, and now I have to specify point on the side offset. So I'm going to need it in the inner side, so I have just click in the inner area. Yeah. So I have got the another extra rectangle. Now I have to explode this rectangle, and so I'm going to use the explode option. So this is the explode option, so I have to use that one. Just click on the explode and just click on the object and enter. Just now I have to divide this line into 6 equal parts, so I have to use the command divide, divide, and to center, and now it is showing that select the object to divide. First, I have to select this line, and now it is showing that enter the number of segments. So number of segments will be 6. Now, okay. Now this line has divided into 6 equal parts. You can see it because the point which are dividing this line are dimensionless. So, we have to go to this format option. We have to go to this format option and just we have to go to then point styles and select this one. Now we can see the point clearly. So first I am going to select the line option and creating a single line, and then I am going to this drop down option and selecting the text, and this I am going to write down a text here. Press and press OK. Now I have to move this. I think this is okay. Now I have to use the arrow. This one is the array icon, so I have to use this. Array option, and we are going with the rectangular array. Rows should be 1 and columns should be 6, and we have to select the array distance from this point to this point, and now select the objects. The objects will be the text and the line, and just press enter and then press OK. Alright, then the last one. Now just we have to edit the text accordingly. What we have done in the upper half, we have to do the same thing in the lower half, lower section. So I am just going to copy this thing, right click and select the option copy selection, and select any base point and set it. And all the things is copied here. So now we have to divide this line, this side line, the left side line. Now I will have to do the same. Just copy these things. Again go to the format option and just select the point styles and select the previous one and this one. Now the margin is okay. Now I have to draw the viewports. For this, go to view. Go to view and then viewports, then single viewport, draw it accordingly. This is your choice. Sorry, this is must be in viewport layer. Okay. Now select the viewport layer and select the lines, straight line option. And draw a straight line. And draw a straight line. Now go again to the offset option, specify offset distance from this point to this point, and object this and this. Okay. Now in this section you can write your name, rule number, and drawing the title and other stuffs, and specify the scale, the angles, and in this region you can write the material used in the material. You can write the materials used to manufacture your design, and the specification of your design, the dimensions, dimensional specification of your design. Now from clicking on this option, you can go to the model space. So here we will have to drawing. So this is our template. So now we have to save it. Just for this, go to the file option and then go to save as, and select the file type and select the AutoCAD template. This one is AutoCAD template. your Autocad template and rename it as project, rename it. Okay. Now save it. Press again OK. Now this is see here. This is now this is showing us project.dw. The extension is converted from DWG to DWT. So it has become a template file. Now what is the use of template file? So whenever I have to draw in AutoCAD, I don't have to build this margin or this maybe star, this section. I don't have to use that. I can just open this template and start drawing. That's it. That's it for today. Just wait for our next tutorial. Thank you.